was silent except for the faint hum of the old ceiling fan. John sat at his desk, eyes locked on the empty page in front of him. His heart raced, and a familiar pit formed in his stomach. I can't do this. What if it's terrible? What if everyone thinks I'm a joke? The thoughts hit him like waves crashing on a shore, each one stronger than the last. He tried to focus, but the weight of his self-doubt was suffocating. His fingers hovered above the keyboard, frozen. It wasn't just about the project in front of him. It was about every failure, every mistake, every voice in his head telling him he wasn't good enough. And now, here he was again, trapped in the same endless loop. Why even try? No one believes in me. But deep down, John knew it wasn't about others. The real problem was that he didn't believe in himself. For years, John silently carried this burden. On the outside, he seemed calm, but inside it was pure chaos. Every decision was filled with hesitation and fear, weighed down by self-doubt. He felt stuck, like he could never break free from the chains holding him back. It's funny, he thought, how no one talks about it. Self-doubt. Everyone has it, yet it feels like the loneliest battle in the world. John had always admired characters like Rocky Balboa, fighting against all odds. But in reality, there were no dramatic training montages, no crowds cheering him on, just silence. Why do I feel so stuck? He whispered, staring at the screen. The emptiness of it reflected the emptiness he felt inside. Then, something shifted. That night, as John sat there, paralyzed by his own thoughts, he realized something he had never fully understood before. No one was coming to save him. No magic moment, no inspiring mentor, no sudden epiphany would pull him out of this. If he wanted to break free from this self-imposed prison, he would have to do it himself. And for the first time, John truly understood. It's me. I'm the one who has to believe in me. The next morning, doubt came back as expected, its familiar voice whispering, "You're wasting your time, this will never work." But this time, John did something different. He pushed back. He sat at his desk, heart pounding, and started typing. The words didn't come easily. In fact, each one felt like a battle. His mind kept telling him to stop, that it wasn't worth it, but he refused to listen. Just one sentence, he told himself. Just get one sentence down. And he did. Then another, and another. It wasn't perfect. It wasn't even good. But it was there. That was when John realized something profound. Progress matters more than perfection. In the next few days, the doubt didn't go away. It never does. But each day, John pushed back a little more. He sat at his desk and kept typing. Whenever the voice told him to stop, he reminded himself, perfection isn't the goal. It's about progress. As days turned into weeks, the voices got quieter. The doubt didn't disappear, but it lost its grip on him. For the first time in a long while, John felt in control. One night, as he finished his project, John leaned back, took a deep breath, and realized he had done it, without waiting for permission or needing validation. The room was still, but inside John felt alive in a way he hadn't for years. He realized something that would stay with him forever. I don't need to be perfect. I just need to keep going. In that moment, John understood that self-doubt never truly goes away. It will always be there, lurking in the shadows, waiting for a moment of weakness. But that's okay. What matters is what you do when it shows up. John's journey wasn't about grand victories or fame. It was about something much deeper. It was about standing up to the voices in his head that told him to quit. It was about choosing to believe in himself, even when it felt impossible. We all have doubts, every one of us. It's part of being human. But the real question is, how will you respond? Will you let your doubts define you? Or will you fight back, day by day, step by step, like John did? Because in the end, it's not about having no doubts. It's about pushing forward despite them.